So being shy is a personality trait, and that's not necessarily a negative one. Actually, in many settings and in many cultures, being shy or introverted can actually be a virtue. For somebody with a social anxiety disorder, it goes above and beyond that, to the point where there's an intense anxiety where it's very distressing. We are social animals, and so a lot of times you have to be around other people in your work or socially or anything like that. And really what it is when people are placed in a situation where they have to be scrutinized by other people. And so you can imagine how if that is an extreme anxiety every time you're put into that situation, just how impairing that can be. Can it get acutely worse? Yes. If your boss suddenly tells you, you have to go present at a national conference and be around a bunch of people during that time and interact with them, that could correspondingly make a social anxiety disorder much worse during that time frame, because now you're being thrust into that particular position, whereas you might have been able to accommodate your life to avoid it before. Now you're being front and center. It's possible that they could do it, you know, given enough preparation, enough forcing themselves, going up and doing it, but it's unlikely. They could choose to quit or just remove themselves or take a demotion. And that's one of the problems with a social anxiety disorder, is that it impairs you from doing things that you sometimes need to do to either further your social or occupational life. The first thing is to recognize if it's become problematic in your life. So if you're noticing it and it's become something that's impairing, you're not able to do certain things, or you're not able to advance in a position, or people are mentioning it to you regularly, it might be time to get that checked out. So for many of the anxiety disorders, including social anxiety disorder, there are multiple options. You know, through our department, through our psychiatrists, our social workers, our psychologists, our residents, and our medical students. So luckily we have a lot of different options here to be able to manage this.